the most part, parents are very excited to see their kids involved in sports, except when it comes to boxing, where parents are hesitant to even let their kids get involved in the sport. Same goes with John Molina. His father, John Molina Sr., didn't really let his son get into boxing until they had a man-to-man talk.
Many parents, when their kids say, hey, dad, mom, I want to get into boxing, parents are like, no, go play basketball, go play. How did you respond when John said he wants to be a fighter?
Well, that's a little bit of a story. John was in college. I had him in school. And he took it on his own to not go, and I found out. And we had a discussion. I found out he was going over to Baldwin Park to a gym. Then after a father-son discussion on all that, I felt, you know what, I'm going to give him that chance. And I told him, don't worry about anything. I'm going to take care of all your bills, everything. You stay here with us, and we'll go after this dream together. And, you know, after 22 amateur fights, knocking out 17 of them, we made the move to pros.
John, you're like the Klitschko of lightweight because you're way taller than everybody. Everybody's like 5'3", 5'4", 5'5". And you're like 5'11". How does that help you in the ring?
My reach, but if you see me, I like to fight on the inside. But I can do it from both standpoints, inside and outside.
As a parent, forget as a boxing fan. When your son's in there, what goes through your mind?
As a parent, you're in there, you're feeling every punch. I would come out of him sometimes more drained than he was. But to be honest with you, recently, it seems to all be coming into fruition now with John. I'm more relaxed like he is.
With Joe, he's taught me the whole game.
He's a world champion right here, baby.
And right here, we got Stuart Little. He's ready to get in the ring. Take care of business.
Ratatouille,
there he is.
My father did it, my grandfather did it, and I did it. So John's a fourth generation fighter, you know, and I just believe that he has all the aspects, like you referred to, his height, you know, his power. John can knock you out with either hand. There's not too many fighters now that can knock you out with one shot.
Look. Tell me he ain't Roman Greek.
Look at that nose. It looks like a femur bone on my face.
Man. Come on.
Hey, I heard you do a killer Rocky impression.
Who?
Get the one.
That's a cross between Joe Cortez and Rocky.
If Rocky and Joe Cortez had a baby, I'm thinking that's how it would sound. One of these days you gotta come in the spar and I'll be the special guest referee and you can check it out.
What can you do about Joe Goosen?
Joe, you know, we love Joe, man. I even told Joe, I think you're gonna save my son's life here because of the way he's training him now. John now, he has all the aspects of the game coming together now with Joe. His defense is much better. His package is a lot tighter.
So who do you think is the best pound-for-pound boxer alive right now in the world?
So you got a lot of people don't like his style, but you got to look at Floyd Mayweather. You know, they say he's a runner, but, you know, the guy gets the job done, no matter who gets in front of him. You know, and another favorite of mine was the man who just fought, Marquez. I just think he was in a weight division he didn't need to be in.
You're in the ring with Floyd Mayweather Jr. How do you penetrate?
Go right after him. He's gonna try to move, I'm gonna go right after him. You know, I'm a fighter. If I shied away from any person that you threw me in the ring with, and I wouldn't be a fighter. You know, right now I'm at the stage where I'm starting to take off, but we'll cross that bridge when it comes.
If they made a movie about you, which Hollywood celebrity would play you?
Oh, wow. Ashton Kutcher. He's a jokester.
Manny Pacquiao, Miguel Cotto, who wins?
That's gonna be interesting. You know, Cotto hasn't been the same since the Margarito situation, so it's gonna be very interesting to see where he's at. You know, where he comes out. Manny's Manny. He's on top right now. What are you going to do? I still see a lot of openings when Manny fights. Manny, to me, still fights kind of well, but he's sharp. And he's sharp and he's quick, but he does open up a lot. Let's see if Cotto can, expose that.
Can you imitate Mike Tyson?
Oh, no, I can't do that. That guy, only in the ring, when you see my knockouts, it's the only way I can imitate.
They call you Mike Tyson lightweight, right?
Yeah, they said I've been Tyson-ish, but I like to, I want to burn my own trail, so we'll see what happens when I get in there.
Your son now gaining notoriety. He's becoming famous. What have you seen when you go places with him and people now already recognize him?
Yeah, that's kind of fun because it happens a lot now, you know. Especially boxing fans.
What's your nickname these days?
My nickname is John Molina Jr. and the Pantera Killer. This, double that, double this, double that, double. There it is. I'm a jokester. How about my boy Dion over here?
Dion, what can you tell me about John Molina?
jokester, just like he said.
Why? What has he done to you?
Everything you can possibly think of.
You punk people. What's the craziest prank you've done?
Oh, man, I've done some bad stuff. I glued a teacher to my seat one time, and to her seat. She got up, I took the glue, I stuck it all, it was in eighth grade. I threw it all right there. She got back, she sat down. It didn't work because she was kind of a heavy set woman. She got back up, and she had a big glue mark, Elmer, set up all over the backside. It was great.
You
two are, Saturday schools I got for that.
His next fight will be November 28th. It's being put together now. It'll be a local venue here in California. It'll be Showtime, Showbox, and John will be the main event, his first 10-round fight.
In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.